Hello everyone!
Welcome to our YouTube channel. I'm Virginia.
I'm Kazuya.
And we are an Italian-Japanese couple who finally closed the distance after being in a long-distance relationship for 3 years. Mm. In today's video, we'll be answering all the questions you asked us on Instagram. Mm. So let's get started.
Are you planning to live in Japan? Will you live in Japan for the rest of your life, or are you here just for the studies and then back? How long are you going to stay in Japan?
Definitely, I'm not here for just study. Mm. I'm here mainly because I am finally living with Kazuya. So far, I really love Tokyo, so
Shibuya especially.
Yeah, especially Shibuya. So I will actually love to live in Japan. Of course, I miss my family so much. We are finding like a balance. We are coming back to my country with Kazuya for Christmas and also next year for summer.
So basically work remotely 100%. So I can work anywhere, you know, as long as I have my computer. So I'm trying to go to Italy for the entire summer. And I work there instead of, you know, working in Japan, so that she can get to stay with her family, grandparents, you know, cousins. So we're trying to make find a balance for both of us.
Something you love about your partner, peeves of each other. How often do you fight since you started living together in Japan?
Something I love about you is how caring she is, and also how cute she is. She's so cute. Whenever you know she eats something good, or whenever she feels good, she shows such a like beautiful emotion that I never had in my life, which is so cute. And whenever she finds something cute on the street, you know, her face turns like, huh? Yeah, that's so cute, and I love that. And what about you?
About me, how passionate you are, and how calm you are. Yeah, that makes me feel super safe.
Yeah, our personality, she's quite dramatic.
Quite
dramatic. her emotion is like twing, 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 twing. And mine's like
yeah. Something you find annoying about me?
No. A little bit. She's sometimes impatient. That's it.
Fair enough.
What about you?
He works too much, too hard. When it's 7 p.m., I want him to stop. He takes great care of what he's doing, and he wanna finish it, even if he can postpone it to the next day. Which I also admire, because it means that you're really passionate in what you do and you put a lot of effort in what you do. But still try to find a balance, because I want you to take care of your health as well.
Oh, well, I kind of want to know about everyone's opinion on this. So I work from 10 a.m. until 7 p.m.
9:30 or 9:20 or 9. Let's be clear.
Yeah, so let's say I work from around 9 a.m. And I finish around 7:30, which is like 9 hours of work, 9-10 hours. And I think it's pretty normal, but she thinks it's too much. So let me know your, you know, comment, you know, leave us comment and tell us about your ideas.
And how often do we fight since we started living together? I would say we were fighting more during our long distance relationship.
Yeah, since we very fight, she wanted to bring some drama, you know. But since I'm good at avoiding. How old are you? How tall are you guys? Both of you look awesome in kimono.
Thank you.
Grazie.
I'm 24 years old.
I'm 29. How tall are you?
158 centimeters. You know.
my height is 171.
How is living together. I also have a Japanese boyfriend, but he isn't as emotional as me. Is your boyfriend too? How do you deal with your cultural difference? Do both of you biggest culture shock about the other one's culture? I would say depends by your partner personality.
Agree. Well, cultural difference for me, I mean, they're not much, but for sure, 100% sure, I eat more pasta, pizza, cheese,
cafe latte, breakfast,
biscuit, olive oil, extra virgin olive oil.
Also bread.
Bread.
Italian bread.
Yes, I barely eat rice now.
Inu to neko, dochi ga suki desu ka? Konnichiwa, Arina.
Konnichiwa.
難しいです。全部可愛いです。全部可愛い。犬です。可愛いです。可愛いです。yeah.
I love dog too. Yeah, they're pretty cute. Have you ever experienced discrimination as a foreigner?
Not really. Sometimes when I commute, some people stare at me, but I think it's simply because they're curious to see, you know, a foreigner. But I wouldn't say that's a discrimination.
How is your Japanese language level?
So I've been studying Japanese since I came here, so it's been more than 6 months. I feel that I'm doing some progress little by little.
I see massive progress. Yes. When you came here, you could even read Japanese alphabets.
Thank you.
It's going like, you know, increasing dramatically. Virginia, do you speak Japanese?
ちょっと日本語を話せます。
あなたの名前は何ですか？
私の名前はビルジニアです。どうぞよろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。So cute. In which language do you speak usually?Yeah, we speak English, I would say 99% of the time. And sometimes Japanese, sometimes Italian.
Sometimes we mix, but yeah. Not really.
Yeah, mostly English. What is your major?
I majored in translation studies with specialization in marketing and communication.
How long is your student visa?
For 8 years. It will expire next March. I'm Japanese and my boyfriend is Italian and we are in a long distance relationship. Any tips for making it work? Love you guys. Thank you. How did you deal with missing your love in a long distance relationship? How did you cope with the time difference? What is your advice for long distance relationship?
Well, I would say be a call every day. No matter how busy you are, try to call every day. You know, even 5-10 minutes, fine. Just go every day. You know, this dedication will make such a huge difference.
Yeah. Even if you're busy with work or with school, making some time for the other person shows how much you care and love, you know.
Sometimes I was calling her at midnight, sometimes 1 a.m., 2 a.m. Since I was hanging out with my friend, I came home late, but still I wanted to call her. So I even let's try 5-10 minutes. We call each other.
Setting a final goal, knowing when you're actually gonna close the distance will dramatically help.
Not only final goal, but also short-term or mid-term, I would say goal or plans. You know, for example, let's try to meet up in this country in 3 months or next, you know, half year. Then you might feel there's some excitement before finish the goal, so you wouldn't feel lonely or you wouldn't feel sad.
While waiting, you can make a PowerPoint with all the places and restaurants, anything you wanna do once you're finally together. That will make you feel excited.
Yeah, we made a lot of PowerPoint.
And once back home, you can review all the pictures you took and you can make albums, you know, to keep the memories alive. And that's what we did. We made 3 albums. The first one was Maldives when we first met. The second one was 2021 when he came to Italy for the first time for Christmas, where he also met my family for the first time. And the last one was summer 2022. Again, he stayed with my family, and also it's when I graduated from university and I had a big party with my boyfriend and with my friends. So also my friends finally met him. So yeah, we have all the memories here. And another thing was we were sending each other a love letter through email every month to remember of the day we started a relationship. And that was, that sounds a bit cheesy, but it was actually super useful. And also sending each other packages for Christmas, birthdays, Valentine's Day, you know.
You send your package for your partner's birthday, and you guys video call each other, and you know, you see him or her opening the package and a beautiful smile happening. How did you guys meet? What is the most difficult thing of being in a national couple?
We met online on a language learning app. The most difficult thing of being international couple is definitely not being able to properly talk with his family, because his mom, she's very sweet with me, so sometimes I want her to know how grateful I am, you know, but I always need Kazuya to translate, and so sometimes I feel bad for
she
that.
Feels, you know.
But I'm learning Japanese for him, so soon.
I would say another thing is that wherever you are, you or your partner's family will be away. That could be really hard. Mm. When and where did you guys meet for the first time?
In Maldives, which was one of the fewest countries that was allowing tourists to enter without being in quarantine. That was September 2020. So we actually had to wait for a year and a half before meeting in person for the first time. That was the hardest period of my life, but it was worth it.
Yeah, it was such a beautiful moment when I saw her at airport. Her smile, tears, everything was so... What makes you both interested in each other?
How funny he was, and how...
Was?
No, I mean, you are. The way I was feeling around him made me feel super comfortable and safe. What made you fall in love?
For me, there are many things, but if I had to pick one, how lovely she is. She's so sweet, especially of course with me, but also with her family. And I love that, how caring she is towards her family. That's a pretty big thing.
Are you guys engaged? Are you planning to get married someday? When will you get married? Are you married, or how can you live together?
We're not engaged yet. Not yet. But of course I'm thinking about, you know, having family or having kid with, you know, beautiful Virginia. Yeah, so one day when the time comes.
So these were all the questions. I hope you enjoy it. If you have more questions, please leave a comment. See you next video. I don't know, maybe next year. A year later. No.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. I'm used to